after a day of clear weather, we are now starting to see some light rain just off the coast of Western Australia. And the weather about 1,000 miles from here in the search zone, we're told, has been similar. Relatively calm seas, which was good for search crews today because they weren't distracted by those white caps on the waves, white caps that can easily be mistaken for possible debris floating in the water. Even though the visual search is now over for the day and these planes from a number of different countries are flying back to Pearce Air Base in Perth, we know that the underwater search, the sonar, is going to be active 24/7. Their U.S. Navy towed pinger locator behind the Australian ship, the Ocean Shield, is going to be functioning literally 24/7 underwater, listening for any possible signal from the in-flight data recorders from Flight 370. But the problem is, with all that sophisticated technology, the TPL, the submarine that's in place, and then the ship that's using sonar equipment as well, all of that technology is just fine, but it needs a more narrowed search area than what we have right now. The search area needs to be about 100 times smaller for this technology to effectively locate possible debris. And those are answers that we simply don't have right now.